How many of you had replaced a key somewhere and you turn around, it's gone? What happened? A lot of us, we place an item somewhere and then as soon as we turn around, it's gone. Then after a couple seconds or a minute, we find it right there where we left it at. Now, a lot of people do believe that this is because the item, it jumps to a different dimension. That's true. To where we can't see it in this reality because it doesn't exist in our eyes in this reality. Therefore, it exists in a different dimension. I want to say this phrase right here. As above, so below. As within, so without. When you place your key, whatever it is that you place, when you put this item, when you put it somewhere and it disappears, it does not mean that it's not there. It is there, but it just doesn't exist in your reality. But it does exist in another reality within a couple seconds. You can call this time lapse. Again, as above, so below. And sometimes these accidents happen, but we let it go. We're like, oh, I know. I put it right here. There it is. I knew it. But where did it go? But we let these events go because we can't explain it. The human mind is programmed that whatever it is that they can explain, they let it go. We've been, a lot of us seen weird stuff going on, shadow people, weird dream, but we let it go because we can't explain it. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to The Mind is the Altar. I want you to watch this clip right here before we start. And if you just now tune in, feel free to subscribe and hit the like button. And also feel free to share.
Just you pre-best waste away.
Oh, I'm a waste.
Yeah, oh,
she wouldn't want to go on a date with you because you make like what, like $2.50 an hour? Surprisingly angry at that. You're gonna make fun of my hair.
Hey. Hey guys, do you see the
I needed some air.
Come on. You're up on Dig Dug. Let's take that top score back, huh?
As you can see, the kid, his friends, they couldn't see the other world, the unseen, the other dimension. But he can. I don't know, it's because he's on his highest frequency. He's aware, whatever it is, that sometimes we do, not all of us, very rare, unless you're in an Illuminati cult or something, and they will show you all this stuff. But those who are not aware, we don't know this stuff. But there are people who can tap in into the different dimension, and they can see a different reality that looks like this reality right here, but it's different. And that brings me to my the dream world. I said this before. We all know that when we are dreaming, we're not aware of this reality. It doesn't exist. No, it don't. We don't even know where our body's laying. Our conscious and subconscious mind, everything is focused on the dream world. That is our new reality. We're all aware of that. We become aware of this reality only when we snap out of it from the other reality, right? Now, there are people who came forward and talked about how they got initiated into occultism. Whatever you want to call it, Freemason, Illuminati, whatever you want to call it. And this is very interesting because they said, like, just like when they say that life is spiritual. See, everything's happening to you right here, right now. It has happened in the spiritual world to you, right? For example, let me give you an example, because it was, I think it was 2 days ago, the other day. I dreamed that I locked my car. So this is not even, it's not even a joke. This is seriously. And that kind of validated my point on making this video. I dreamed that I locked my car. I locked my keys. I locked my keys in my car. And I don't know why, because I was dreaming. My dream was different, but this just happened to where I was shown in my dream that I locked my keys in my car. And then I couldn't get them out. But then I just woke up, right? Because my alarm rang. So I come to work. My coworker on his lunch time, and this happens 3 days ago, he comes to me and says, hey, when you're taking a break, we're going to take a break together because I need your help. Because I locked my keys in my car. Right there, it hit me. As above, so below. As within, so without. Sometimes dreams, they have bigger message. They play a big part in your reality. Excuse me. Now, let's go back to people who get initiated in a dream. Some people who wants to join an occult. The spirits who don't have physical body, they cannot interact with you. They cannot really interact with you how they want to in this physical realm with your flesh body. You can see them, but you can walk with them. But if you want to be, sometimes if they want you to see their world, to be initiated in their world. Now, this is coming from people who've been initiated in occultism or Illuminati Freemason. They say that somebody will come to you, right? And they will tell you, tonight, you're going to have a visitor in your dream and follow that visitor and follow instruction. Someone has said that they had somebody in their dream. They come to them. And also, I don't know if you know about the marine underworld. They came to them. It was a female. And as he followed this female, and she said, I heard that you wanted to join. This is so and so and so. He was very aware that this happened in reality. He said, yes. Because when they come to you in a dream, they will wake you up. Now you're aware. Now you're in a different realm. So he was dreaming. They came to them and the women said, follow me. They went underneath the water. As he said, as he followed this woman in the water he could walk in deep down. This is a whole new reality, a whole reality in the water to where he can walk in there and breathe. And when he looked up, the water was above. Right? And that's when, you know, he went down there and then he got initiated, drinking blood, whatever you want to say. And when he woke up, he went down there, I can tell this story because I think I have time. He went down there and they told him that there was a lot of people out there, but they didn't look like normal people. He said that he's seen people with, they look like sirens, mermaid. And there were also people that he knew in this reality that are famous people who go there every night to get their power. He's seen pastors, fake pastors, to get their power. You know how the pastors, when they touch you, you know, you jump or you fly, the Holy Ghost, whatever. Some pastors are working with the devil themselves. I just got to call it. They go there, get their power. This power so they can pull more people in their church. But he went down there and he saw all these people that he knew over here. But you can't, he can't speak about it because now you join them. If you speak about it, you're out by blood. But he went there and then he was surrounded by a whole bunch of, you know, you can call them beasts, mermaids, sirens, whatever, and people that he knew. He laid on a table. He drank blood. They initiated him. They gave him his amulet, charm. They gave him his instruction what to do. And then he said the lady told him, now you can wake up. And then he was, the next thing you know, he was up on his bed. And they gave him a phone call. And they asked him, so how did it go? Now, for somebody in this reality to know that they can go to your dream and initiate you into a cult and call you after you wake up, that's crazy. But then that's not crazy. That's just the reality that we live in. That's just how things are. We don't know everything because we don't see everything. We are so used to our own reality, you know, go to work, come back and pay bills, whatnot. When they say this is spiritual warfare, they're not talking about physical. These shadows or demons, they don't need your physical body. They need your soul, the real you. Your physical body is just a shell that's going to be buried when you're out of it. And then, you know, but your soul, wherever it ends up, is very important. So again, as above, so below. Whatever is happening to you right now, it already is happening in the spiritual world. Sometimes when they want things to happen, they make it happen in the spiritual world, in the spiritual world first, then the next day will happen here in our reality. There's a whole reality in the spiritual realm that looks exactly like this reality. Your company, this, everything that is associated with a cult. But we can carry this on because I'm running out of time. I just want to say, stay aware and stay safe. And welcome to the Mind is the Altar.